தொடர்ந்து குடியரசு துணைத் தலைவர் வெங்கையா நாயுடு அவர்களுடைய உரையை தற்போது பார்க்கலாம்.
The system. So this is another important session. These suggestions are for Supreme Court and for Parliament and to the government. I am only giving suggestions as the Vice President and as the Chairman of Rajya Sabha. What is required is demystification of the process. It is generally noticed that an efficient, transparent, accessible and affordable judicial system is key touchstone of good governance which can improve the ease of doing business as well as ease of living. My dear sisters and brothers, in order to three pillars of our polity, we have the fourth estate, the media, which plays an important role in shaping public discourse, enhancing accountability of the government, and providing news and views on various events around the world. A free and vibrant media keeps democracy alive and can enrich the quality of life of people through information, education, entertainment, and insightful analysis. The technological advancement in recent years have brought unprecedented change in the media landscape. Social media, along with traditional press and TV, are having a profound influence on our lives and lifestyles, on our work and relationship. Like everything else in life, this transformation has the good, bad and the ugly. You are seeing what is happening in the electronic media in some instances, what is happening in print media in some instances, what is happening in the social media also. Information is very important in this advancement of the civilization and development. Information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. If your information is with confirmation, it is more than an ammunition to fight against corruption, injustice, exploitation. All these things, you have to have correct information. The media should see to it that they provide correct information. And there is another problem that has come in the recent days. They combine news and views. News is separate. Views should be separate. Views should be left to editorial page. Or if that is not sufficient, you can have one more page also to add your views, your ideas, your all these things. But the news should be news. But nowadays, no, we have so many channels making news, breaking news, good news, bad news. Nahi to khud unka news, ek dusri ke khilaf news. Aaj tak, kal tak, sidhi baat, ulti baat, kitna baat hai, yaad rakhna bhi mushkil hai. And they say, oh sir, then immediately they'll go to Amit Shah, they'll go to Prakash Javadekar, sir, this is the headline. And they must be able to say, your headline is not going to be deadline for me, don't worry, I have my own line. One must have that much courage, na? That much information and confidence. The media, yes, should give the news and leave it, the judgment, to the people. That should be the order of the day. And they must have a self-code of conduct to start with. Like the print media, there is a Press Council of India. For electronic media also, some such thing should come. And I think some beginning has been made and it should be improved further to have some sort of accountability. Otherwise, you are seeing nowadays promoting hatred, division, discontentment. Media should be a dispassionate watchdog, an honest messenger, a friendly advisor, and a wholesome entertainer. This is the ideal we must aim to achieve. Media should also, like other organs of the governance, be more accountable for the authenticity and objectivity of the content. Media should also be the catalyst of a positive change and voice of the voiceless. It should combine information with confirmation that is considered to be more powerful than ammunition. It should question and seek answers and present the agreed truths in such a manner that social transformation occurs in the positive direction. It should help build public awareness and motivate people to join societal movements for cleanliness, health, hygiene, and education. I have dwelt at length on the foundation of our governance system. We are proud inheritors of an ancient civilization that had an excellent governance system based on sound theoretical and philosophical basis. We have to rebuild this edifice on new solid foundations. In 1947, we have struggled hard through 72 years to shape India as a vibrant democracy. We have done reasonably well. My various governments have done their best. There may be degrees of difference with regard to speed, with regard to, but development has taken place in the country. But this is not a movement to be complacent. World is moving faster. We must also move faster. And aspirations, 65% of the Indian population is below 35 years. They are very aspirational. Earlier, people used to go 50 years to a party, 40 years to a party. Now, after 5 years, people are asking, what you have said, what you have done. Expectations are very high. So we have to always be on charayaveti, charayaveti, like our ancient sages who have exhorted us. We must move on, move forward. We should focus on the 5 Ds I have already mentioned. Discuss, debate, decide. Then decentralize and deliver. This can transform the quality of our life, of our polity. Please take note. as we have excellent set of circumstances to transform our country. We are a young and aspirational India, and we have untapped demographic dividend, a fundamentally sound economy that is growing faster than most of the other countries, a pool of front-ranking individuals, and a strong leadership at all levels. If we can combine our collective competence for a common good, we can easily achieve mission we have set for ourselves. We cannot be only $5 trillion economy, but also a more vibrant democracy based on our civilizational values of tolerance, inclusion, and harmony. We should tap into our enormous resources for both human and material. We should incorporate values and ethics into education system. Very important. The new recommendations made by committee, they consist this part also. Earlier during my school days, I remember, we used to have a moral science class. Now only science, morals have gone. We used to have a craft class. We used to have a gardening class. And we used to have physical training compulsory. No physical training now. Because schools are run in multi-storied buildings. We must revisit. And then half the time in the classroom, remaining time on the ground or in the field. That should be the approach in the coming days as far as education is concerned. We should preserve the best aspects of our rich cultural heritage. And India has a rich linguistic diversity and literary heritage. I have been repeatedly suggesting children should have an opportunity to study in their mother tongue at least up to primary stage. This will enable Indian languages to be preserved and children will strengthen their foundation and cognitive abilities. I am not against other languages. You must learn English also. But first you must learn mother tongue. As I say everywhere, I have made a principle to say everybody should remember mother, motherland, mother tongue. Mother tongue is like your eyesight. If you know mother tongue, that means your eyes are working. The eyes are like mother tongue. Spectacles are like other language. If you have eyesight, then if you have these spectacles, it will improve your sight and also you can use your foresight. But if you don't have even sight, blind, even if you wear Ray-Ban glasses also, nothing is visible. So have foundation in Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Punjabi, Assami, Urdu, whatever, Tulu, Bhojpuri, any language of your choice, because bhasha or bhavana ek saath chalta hai. So no language should be opposed. I am in Chennai. I know I am talking before my colleagues. No language should be opposed. So my simple principle is no imposition and no opposition. That is my supposition and proposition. That should be the position of the government. Why should we oppose any language? But no language should be thrust forcefully. And children do not have the facility. They are writing language, postal this thing in Tamil. They force it to other language. So we all discussed together. And then I called the minister. Minister also was kind enough to cancel the exam. And again, they are going to reconduct the exam. We should do it. But at the same time, if you don't learn other languages, you will be deprived. You will not be able to stand competition. Today, I have been able to come up to this level because I picked up some other language other than my mother tongue also. Learn English. It's an international language. No problem at all. But first, promote your mother tongue. At home, speak in your mother tongue. With your mother, brother, sister, and in the street and surroundings, speak in mother tongue. But the problem is not with the students. The problem is the parents, old parents. They say, Babu, say, mummy, daddy. Why this mummy, daddy, bidi, jadi? Why don't you say, ma, amma? I'm not talking of Jayakumar's amma. Or Palani Swami's amma. Palani Swamiji is having amma even now also in his pocket. That is their faith. We should not have any objection for that. Either amma or ayya, that is your choice, is your personal. You are Tamil Nadu has the advantage of having amma also, ayya also. Both are very eminent people. Choice is people. But question is amma, and you say like that, it comes from the heart. You say, mummy, it comes from here. So that is the difference. So please promote mother tongue, all state, and give opportunity to others also, people of other language. The other day, there was an interesting question or discussion in the parliament saying that in other states also, Tamil schools should be allowed. Yes, but in your state also, other language schools also should be allowed. That should be understood. So this is a given talk. People are now the country. People are moving around. A lot of people are there, even here. But we must make a rule for administration. The administration, the local language knowledge is must. That mandate has to be there. Everybody who is there in service in Tamil Nadu, they should learn Tamil. Definitely, that should be. even if you are a Telugu man or a Kannadiga or Marathi and all, you have to learn, because if you want to do job and still you don't want to learn the local language, you cannot do justice. So this has to be, approach has to be there. As we shape our future, we must certainly focus on making agriculture the last point. The central and state government must work together to provide inputs, implements, insurance, infrastructure, credit warehousing and marketing in an integrated manner. Diversification of crops, supplementation of farmers' incomes through activities like dairy, poultry, agroforestry and aquaculture are all value addition. I appeal to all of you on this occasion, these five items I suggested about legislature, about executive, about judiciary and also about the societal behavior. Societal behavior, change in societal behavior also is equally important. Mere law, mere government alone cannot transform the country or the society. I just recall one small thing and conclude. When there was a discussion, in our country we have developed a system. Anything happening, bring a new law. New law. Hyderabad University, one law. Nirbhaya, one law. Now the latest is mob lynching, one law. There are enough laws. We have to implement it. That's the problem. So I remember, I am not against the new law. People may say, Vice President do not want anti-lynching. It's a crime already under the law. So I remember in 2012, when this Nirbhaya Prakaran came, discussion was on, and people are saying, arguing for new law and all. I stood up. I was not supposed to speak. I told Mr. Chairman, now I am the chairman. At the time, I was a member. So I took the permission of chairman. Mr. Chairman, I want to say just say few lines. I said, what is required is not a new bill. What is required is political will, administrative skill, and go for the kill of the social evil. That's what is required. These are all social evils. You must mobilize the society. Change the mindset. You have the great examples of reformists in Tamil Nadu. I need not take their names and all. But you know what is happening in certain parts, even in Tamil Nadu also. Not only this government or that government, that's not the issue. We should not politicalize it also. So we have to create social awareness among the people and then set good examples by leaders. My dear friends, I thought here being in a historic city, in the company of such great intellectuals, we are making a good contribution to the cause of society. And also on the completion of 2 years of my office as Vice President, I thought I should share some of my thoughts with the people of the country through you from Chennai today. That's why I have taken a little more time. Thank you very much for the support you have extended for the success of this program. I could see almost who is who from various fields of Chennai and also people coming from other areas also. Yesterday, I noticed one thing in a newspaper. This Article 370, now Home Minister has piloted it and you are all appreciating him for the historic this thing and all. I also feel, as even now that bill is passed, now I can be free to speak. That's the need of the hour. It's a good thing. I was also really under tension, as Amit Bhai was saying, because as chairman, you have to conduct the house to see to it, and at the same time, the business is carried up. But you know nowadays what is happening and all. I don't want to remove the members, use force, like what happened on the Telangana, Andhra, this thing and all, closing the doors, stopping the Doordarshan, and then removing 30, 40 people. I was praying and I was thinking how to come, because the bill, instead of going to Lok Sabha, it has come to Rajya Sabha. Because they seems to have decided we must first cross the hurdle in Rajya Sabha itself so that we can go to Lok Sabha and all. Okay, government has got every right. So the bill came before me. I gave a serious thought and then I was hoping. But luckily, members from all sides, they all spoke. There was a proper voting also and there was division also. And then by 2/3 majority, 370 has been abrogated. And some people are saying, you have, no, suddenly all of these things and all. It's not sudden. I was surprised to read yesterday's Hindustan Times newspaper. Special status of Kashmir must end, insist MPs. This is 1964. Now we are in 2019. This happened in Parliament. All sides, Prakash Veer Shastri, independent member, he moved the bill. K. Hanumantayya, Congress, and also H.V. Kamath, and also Bhagwatja Ajad, former Chief Minister of Bihar, D.C. Sharma, Kashiram Gupta, Saroj Pandey, and then H.V. Kamath, Ram Manohar Lohia. A lot of people, they all spoke about the bill, and the report says Shyamlal Saraf, Indrajit Malhotra, and G.D. Mengi from Kashmir, they all said the state has suffered enough, now the Article 370 must go.
குடியரசு துணைத் தலைவர் வெங்கையா நாயுடு பதவியேற்று 2 ஆண்டு காலம் முடிவடைந்ததை மையப்படுத்தி தயாரிக்கப்பட்ட புத்தகத்தின் வெளியீட்டு விழா சென்னை கலைவாணன் அரங்கத்தில் நடைபெற்றது. அதில் அவர் ஆற்றிய உரையை தற்போது நாம் பார்த்தோம். தொடர்ந்து செய்திகளை உடனுக்குடன் தெரிந்து கொள்ள நியூஸ் 18 தமிழ்நாட்டின் ஃபேஸ்புக், ட்விட்டர், யூடியூப் உள்ளிட்ட வலைதள பக்கங்களை பார்க்கவும்.